Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
With a bunch of great acts, with Tracy Nelson, with the Otis Taylor Band, Zephyr, but it took you until 2004 until you released the first album under your own name. Why did you wait that long?
I never wanted to be the front person in a band. I always wanted to be that great guitar player that was hiding out at the back of the stage. So I never wanted to have my own band. And if it wasn't for Kenny, I never would have had one.
How did you meet Kenny Pessoa?
We met years ago, various bands he was playing through town, and through a guy by the name of Billy Kex, who introduced us, because Kenny used to buy furniture, really, really nice furniture, and so it's just a group of people and just kind of met, and then I really got to know him once I started playing with Otis.
And he convinced you that you should be the frontman of a band, too?
Yes, because the original plan was I was going to have a singer for this band, and we get to the studio and he just says, no. He says, you're going to sing. And I went, okay.
That's something what I don't get anyways, because people always are raving about your extraordinary musicianship, like your guitar playing, etc. But I think your voice is outstanding too. It's very, very soulful and rich.
Thank you.
Would you say Thank that you. These days, would you say that you're a natural as a singer too?
No. I have to work at it. I'm still... Sometimes I'm very embarrassed with my voice, but there's so many great singers in this world that, you know, I just don't consider myself one of the best. But I do the best I can.
What does playing live mean to you?
I love
it. To recording?
I love playing live. I love the the vibe of the people in the audience, and I like making people move. And you kind of like you almost like you kind of control them by how you feel and they control you by how they feel, and it's just this wonderful symbiotic relationship that you have with the crowd.
Your music is pretty eclectic, I'd say.
Weird is a better word.
Okay, weird and eclectic.
Okay, great.
Are there any limitations on what you allow to seep into the music?
None whatsoever.
None whatsoever?
None whatsoever. If I believe it and I feel it, then it's perfect. I can't do something that's contrived. I can't do that. But if I just believe it, I'll let anything happen. Or if I like something, if I hear a beat that I think is just exceptional, or Kenny comes to me and says, Eddie, you gotta check this out. And I'll go, oh, wow, that's really great. And then it's all things are possible. I mean, why limit yourself?
Thank you.
So it was just a lie. Spirits dance round that sacred fire. A man, I'm a man, I'm a man.
Yeah.
funky, funky, funky groove. Can you all get funky with me now? You just look just a little bit confused. I said, can we get funky now? I don't know. I just don't know. I just don't know. So I guess I'm just gonna have to get funky by myself. Oh, that girl over there, she getting funky now. Oh yeah, baby. Oh yeah, baby. That's the right thing. Oh yeah. Sun comes up, Deacon walks around. Spirits with them, but I will never find. Mother, son, father, silently well, drown in blood. It's a sacred tale. Thank you very much.
And what does success mean to you?
I think it would mean being able to play music all the time and just totally enjoy myself doing that, never having music be another job or something like that. Be able to get up in the morning and if I want, go record and go out on tour, but always be extremely happy. Success for music. And then that ties in just success in my general life. Just want to be a happy person all the time, every day.
So that's the basic goal that you want to achieve?
Mm-hmm. Pretty simple person.
Are there any career goals that you would like to achieve?
Well, I'd like 15 Grammys, you know, a couple W.C. Handy Awards, you know, a bank account that doesn't run dry. But, you know, those aren't as important as just me getting up and being really happy every day. And music is a huge part of that.
What drives you? What would you say is the general force that forced you to play music and that still forces you to continue playing music? Is it just fun?
I just have to do it. It's a part of me, and it's the one part that I've always wanted to do. And I don't remember when I did not want to play music. I've always wanted to play music. I've always wanted to be in a band, you know, and play with a group of people that I enjoy playing with, or meeting new people to play with and figure out new forms of music that is started with somebody else, and you went, you know, it's really a great idea, but I think we can take it further than that. The whole concept of just trying to create drives me a lot. I mean, to be able to come up with something that is based over here, but when you listen to it, you can't quite see the connection. And then after listening to it or watching it for a while, you see the connection, then all of a sudden it makes sense, and then you can see all these other connections and little dots that come into play. And that's what I really enjoy doing. I like to surprise myself. It is just as important as surprising somebody else.
I tell ya, maybe I won't, probably will, but first, buy you the rings of Saturn, take you to Jupiter, and where you wanna go, why don't you? Come on, come on, don't be shy. Come on, come on, let's fly. what? Tell me. I know something you don't know. Appreciate it. Love being here. Bonn, first time here. It's a wonderful city. Tomorrow, I'll look at it.